I have always suffered from migraine headaches. So I had laid down one night thinking that I had a severe migraine and I just didn't get out of bed again. I was really, really, really sick and I couldn't speak. Everything was coming out like alphabet soup. You couldn't understand what I was saying. I was alone in my home. Both of my parents were crossed over. Any family that I had was hours from me. So I was literally alone with my five-year-old child. To this day, I don't know how long I was actually laying in my bed for. And when I was in that state, a friend of mine texted me on a whim, someone I hadn't spoken with in a couple of years, I wanna say. And she just asked me if I was okay at like 2 in the morning. And I texted her, I was able to text. I texted her back, help. In between the time of me texting her help and the time that she arrived at my house, I kept having this reoccurring dream. I kept seeing my mom by my bedside and she's sitting next to me. I'm 8 years old. I'm back in time. I'm eight. My mom was a single mom. And, you know, we would stay home alone when we were really little if we were sick. And I kept seeing her and she would say, Carolyn, touch your chin to your neck. Okay. And we called it the chin check when we were little. We had no idea why she would ask us to touch our chin to our neck if we had a sore throat when we were little. She kept telling me to do that over and over again. And so I'm sitting up in my head. I'm seeing myself as I'm eight and I'm touching my chin to my neck, you know, and I'm fine. And she gives me a kiss on my head and she says, okay. And she goes to work. Well, this time I'm just seeing this replay over and over and over again in my head. And finally I hear her clear as day and she says, Carolyn, sit up, you know, and touch your chin to your neck. And I'm like, oh, okay. It registers. So I sit up and I try and I can't. And I start projectile vomiting. I know it's gross. I don't know what's going on with me, right? But I can't. It's like my head's fused, right? So then I see an ambulance in my head. She brings it to the forefront of my mind. And then she says, clear as day, she goes, meningitis, right in my ear. And I'm like, I don't know at this point. I don't know what meningitis is. I was completely ignorant to the disease. I had no idea. And I lay back down and I don't remember anything till I'm in the hospital. I guess I've been there for about 8 hours in the ER. They couldn't figure out what's going on with me. I'm dry heaving and stuff. I can't get out any words. Finally, I muster up the word meningitis. And the nurse comes in and says, what did you say? And I say it again. And she's like, oh, we didn't even think of that, right? So they tapped my spine and I did have 2 strains of it. So I was in isolation. Had the heart stent in, the whole 9 yards. My heartbeat was down to 31 beats a minute. They're literally like, you're not going to survive this, right? Because nothing was helping. The only thing that would give me any relief, and this is going to sound kind of corny, but the only thing that would give me relief is my son. When he came in the room after a few days of isolation, they brought him in and my heartbeat raised to 61 beats a minute. So it was like when they took him away, it would drop. When they brought him in, it would raise. And it's just that power of love. Just the fact that he depends so strongly on me, it's like just that alone is powerful enough. So I'm laying there in the hospital bed and I keep crossing over. It was kind of like I was in between two worlds at the same time. I was like 1 foot in and 1 foot out the whole time I was there. And as I'm going, slipping back in between the worlds, I'm seeing my mom. I'm seeing my dad. I'm seeing my friends who've passed over. So I'm like really ecstatic. Like I'm seeing all these people that I haven't seen in a while. So happy to see them. And they're just hanging out. So there's all these people I didn't know as well. And it was as though they were waiting for me to be birthed into the next world. I'm watching all this, but I couldn't at that moment. I wasn't exchanging words. I was watching them and I could hear them, but I couldn't speak to them. Okay. So it was like, I'm there, but I'm not. There's a committee of people, probably about 30 people. And there's one person that I was focused on. It was a female and she had silver hair and she was in the center. And they're just all looking at me, like evaluating me. It felt like I was being evaluated, like I'm just being stared at. They were speaking and I could not understand what they were saying. It was really quiet. And I just asked them, please let me stay for my son. And the woman turned to the person next to her and spoke and then turned back to me and said, yes, if you do this work for us, without moving her mouth. Okay, so she spoke to me without moving her lips. And I heard her and she said, if you do this work for us, And I said, yes. And I had no clue what I was agreeing to. It was just like a very absolute feeling like, well, duh, of course. Like, I'll do anything because I just wanted to stay with my son, you know? And they all gathered back together and they came to this huge white light. And they moved from my feet through my body and up through my head. And I was completely healed. It was on 11-11-11 and I was 100% cured, and they have no idea how. My brain was swollen. My spine was swollen. That's what happens with the illness. And I'm sure there's science behind it. That's all I can say. I'm sure that it has something to do with energy, with science, everything like that. But I feel like my brain was rewired in a way, as odd as that might sound. And the rewiring or the refactoring of it to help me to communicate and be normal again, to not have, you know, missing limbs, to not be brain dead, to not be handicapped. I mean, that took a lot of energy and effort on their behalf, and I owe my life to them. I'm a huge skeptic. I'm somebody who's always been skeptical. I could never adhere to one religion. I was always like, I believe in God and everything, but it's like I was always questioning everything. Whenever I would believe in something, I'd also question it. And I believe in science as well. And I read a lot and I believe in energy. We're a material world. We're meat. That's what we are. We're meat. And meat goes bad, but the spirit doesn't. The spirit moves on. So after I came out of the hospital, I knew what I was seeing. I knew I was seeing spirit. Okay. And I knew because everybody who I ran into that I gave a reading to confirmed, oh, that is so-and-so. And this is exactly how they died. And I knew it. I needed a doctor to tell me, yep, that's exactly what it is. And it's funny, I needed that validation. I needed a doctor. I needed science to say, Carolyn, we can't explain this, but you're not crazy. And so, you know, I went and I spilled the bean. I didn't hold back anything. I was like, here, if you think I'm crazy, like if there's something wrong here, because I had the meningitis, tell me, let's fix it. I went to a cancer doctor. Her loved ones came through when I was sitting in her office. She's like, you speak to people who are crossed over. Like, I don't know what else to say, you know, like you don't have cancer. You know, I went to a psychologist, and when he was asking me questions, I gave him a reading. I went to my family practitioner and he's like, well, what do you see? You know, and I'm like, well, I see your dad in India and you didn't make it to his funeral. He wants to tell you that you need to forgive yourself because you're busy. And, you know, he liked the blanket that you sent him. Every doctor that I spoke with, their loved ones came through. And so they all gave me a clean bill of health. Things happen. It's not all perfect. I mean, this is all one big classroom. You know, bad stuff is supposed to happen so that we can recognize the good and learn.
If you care to watch the full unedited interview, I have it linked right here. Also in the description, if you'd like to see some more of my videos, click right here. If you are new to the channel, you can go ahead and subscribe by clicking on my face right there. Hope you have a good day. See you next time.